Hi, welcome to Sunic. What can I get you?
I just want a number one. She took the kids.
I'm sorry, what was that?
I want a number one!
Okay, would you like mayo, mustard, or ketchup on that?
Yes!
Which one?
I want a Dr. Pepper!
Okay, fries or tots with that?
With easy ice.
Okay, fries or tots?
With a pineapple shake.
I'm sorry, but we don't have pineapple anymore.
What?! Let me talk to your manager!
Peggy? No, I'm sorry, sir. We don't have pineapple.
Oh, okay. I'll take a chocolate then.
I believe everybody should work a fast food or retail job at least once in their life. If everyone worked at least 3 months at one of these customer service jobs, then we would definitely be one step closer to world peace. So with that being said, yes, I do work fast food. Where? Oh, at this place called... a little place called... Sunic. Sunic is an American fast food restaurant, so sorry you other high-class countries, you're too good for our food. I don't know if that's a bad thing. I am the fountain at Sunic, and no, that doesn't mean I stand outside in the lawn and water the grass. No, no, no. I make all the fountain drinks, like sweet, sweet Dr. Pepper, as well as the milkshakes, slushes, sundaes, and coffee, and many, many more. And I love my job. I have met some amazing people thanks to Sunic throughout this entire year, and made bonds with many different people, and it also helps to have some money in the bank. I would definitely recommend working at Sunic. But I used to have faith in humanity, and then I worked fast food. And that's what this video is about, things that happened during my shifts. One time when I was doing dishes, I was looking out the window. A yellow Mustang had pulled up to stall 20. I see them light something in their car, and at first I thought it was a cigarette. That's a weird cigarette.
What was that?
It was stall 20, the yellow Mustang! My boss goes out there to confront them, but they claimed it wasn't them who threw the firecracker, while my boss just stares at the burnt paper by their vehicle. One late afternoon, we had one of our car hops come back in from taking an order out, and she said that the man in the car had a Subway sandwich in his passenger seat while his wife or girlfriend was in the back seat. I guess we know where his priorities were at. There was this one time we were closed, and someone pressed the button to make an order.
Hello, I'm sorry, but we're currently closed right now.
Do you have any food? Peggy? I did all that I could. So Peggy was nice and actually tried to compromise with them. I'm sorry, sir, but the grills are already cleaned. But can we get you a drink instead?
But I want food.
Well, I'm sorry, sir, but we can't help you.
Okay, that's fine.
And then they awkwardly drove off.
Okay, whatever.
Now at Sunic, we have over a million different drink combinations. However, that doesn't mean that all of them are good. Here's a list of some of the weirdest drinks I have made throughout this entire year.
May I have a chocolate Coke, please?
Hi, I'd like a number one with a large strawberry banana Dr. Pepper.
Can I please get a green apple Coke?
One medium chocolate lemonade.
Hello there, can I get a chocolate cream slush?
A large mango vanilla Dr. Pepper with a metal straw.
Yes, I'd like one Dr. Pepper nerd, please.
I would like a large number 10 with a lemon Dr. Pepper.
Oh, can you add a medium mango Diet Coke to my order?
He also had this woman order an M&M slush as an M&M candy and frozen sugar water. That's it. As well as a guy that tried to order a blue raspberry slush with no ice. I love my coworkers at Sunic, as well as our regulars, like one high schooler whose nickname is Big Cheese, who comes to Sonic quite a lot. We call him Big Cheese because he doesn't like cheese. At Sunic, we may give each other a hard time, but at the end of the day, we all love each other. And no amount of screaming children and 40-year-old Karens can change that. Phew, got the animation done. It's been a while since I've done an end card with my voice. So my last day at Sunic is this Sunday, July 28th. Then that means I've worked there for a year and 2 months. I'm moving to Georgia for college, so it was inevitable. But that doesn't mean that it's still not sad. I'll miss the close friends I've made there. And also, side tangent, some of the weird drinks I've made have had strawberries in them. And I don't know if they're gross, because I've never had a strawberry before. I'm allergic. So I've never bitten into a fresh strawberry. I don't know what they taste like. So thanks for watching this. Please like and subscribe. It would really help me out. And don't ruin Dr. Pepper with your weird flavor add-ins.